What is the difference between zero float or slack, free float, and total float? In this video, I'll be using a Gantt chart example to explain the critical path, which contains activities with zero float, as well as the difference between free float and total float. In the example that we will be using, we have 8 activities. That it's task A to task H. We've got the duration, as well as the successor activities of each activity. Now, the successor activities of the start milestone is task A and task B. Task A is connected to C, D, and F. That's a finish to start relationship. Task B is connected to F. Task C is connected to E. Task D is connected to H. Task E is connected to G and H. Task F is connected to G. Task G is connected to H. And task H is connected to the finish milestone. Now let's have a look at the critical path. The critical path is a sequence of activities with the longest path through a project. And the activities on the critical path has got a zero float. So if any of the activities are delayed on the critical path, the project will be delayed. So let's calculate the duration of each path on the Gantt chart, starting off with path 1, which is A, connected to C, connected to E, connected to H. Duration is 6 plus 3 plus 4 plus 2. It's 15 days. Path 2 is A, connected to C, connected to E, connected to G and H. So it's 6 plus 3 plus 4 plus 2 plus 2 is 17 days. Path 3 is A, connected to D, connected to H. So it's 6 plus 10 plus 2, it's 18 days. Then path 4 is A, connected to F, G and H. 6 plus 5 plus 2 plus 2, it's 15 days. And then lastly, path 5 is B, F, G and H. So it's 2 plus 5 plus 2 plus 2, it's 11 days. So the critical path is a sequence of activities with the longest path duration, which is path 3 with 18 days. So that's our critical path. It's A, D and H. So if A, D or H is delayed, the project will be delayed. So that's our critical path. Now let's have a look at our free float and total float. So our free float or slack is the amount of time an activity can be delayed without delaying a successor activity. And the total float is the amount of time an activity can be delayed without delaying the project. So let's have a look at task A. Now task A is one of our tasks on the critical path. So it doesn't have any free float or total float. Task B, on the other hand, has got a free float of 4 days. So it can be delayed by 1, 2, 3, 4 days before it will have an impact on task F. So the free float is 4 days. Now task B is also connected to F. F is connected to G and G is connected to H. So task F has a float of 2 days and G has a float of 1 day. So the total float is 1 plus 2 plus 4 is 7 days. So there's a 7 days total float on task B. So let's have a look at task C. C is connected to E. There's no free float, so it's zero free float. However, for the total float, C is connected to E, E connected to G, and G connected to H, and we've got one day float between G and H. So our total float is one day. Task D is our is one of our task or activities on the critical path. So it's got a zero free float and zero total float. Task E has got zero free float and is connected to G and G connected to H with one day of float. So our total float on task E is one day before it will have an impact on the project. Task F, we've got a free float of 2 days. F is connected to G. And as indicated in the definition, this amount of time and activity can be delayed without delaying a successor activity. So before F have an impact on G, we've got a delay of 2 days. Then G is connected to H. We've got a float of 1 day. So the total float is 1 plus 2 is 3 days. Task G has a free float of 1 day as well as a total float of 1 day. And then task H has got 0 free float and 0 total float. I hope this video will help you to distinguish between 0 float, free float and total float. And if you like this video, give me a thumbs up, or you can subscribe to my channel for more project management related videos. You can also indicate in the comment box any project management related topics that you would like me to discuss in future videos.